should be personal. It should be personal. Upon the first day of the week, let every one of you, let every one of you lay by him in store as God hath prospered. This is for everyone to experience. Now, sometimes personal experiences are the hardest to deal with, and sometimes they're the easiest. I like to say that when it comes to this, I want to be involved. I want to be involved in this process. If I was to ask you, how many of you would like to be part of building a church? I hope all of you raise your hand. If some of you didn't, then that'd be a little bummer. But anyways, I would say that most of you, if not all of you, want to be involved in doing something for God. How many of you would like to see something done for God and not be a part of it? I would be bummed, okay? If God built this church, which he's going to build, it's not going to be me. If he's going to build it with his money that we all give to him, because it's all his anyway. See, it's all perspective. A lot of this is just perspective. I'd be bummed out if I said, I wasn't even a part of that. You know what's nice is you guys, and I mean this legitimately, you guys are like on the ground floor of this. You guys are on the ground floor of God working with this ministry. You guys are all part of this. When we're in that thing 10 years from now, hopefully it's sooner than that, by the way, when we're in this building, we're going to sit back and we're going to look and say, look at all the things God has done. You know what? We're all going to be part of that. We can all say, man, that is so cool to be part like this. We all gave to this. It's exciting, isn't it? This should be a personal thing. We need to be stewards of this. 1 Corinthians 4:2, moreover, it is required in stewards that a man be found faithful. God has called us to be faithful. That's what it is. God has called us to be faithful. And it's a very personal thing.